In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning. I'm Father Dennis Robinson, the President Rector of St. Meinrad Seminary and School of Theology. And on behalf of our faculty, our staff, and our students, I'm very happy to welcome you on this beautiful day for our celebration of ordination to the diaconate of four of our brothers. It's a particular joy to welcome our own Archbishop Thompson, as well as the many family members and friends and guests and priests who have joined us on this special day. Welcome to all.
Thank you, Father Dennis, and thank you for the great work of St. Meinrad Seminary, as well as the Archabbey, and all that you do, and your great witness and presence here in Southern Indiana in the Archdiocese of Indianapolis. Grateful always for the great formation that you provide for our priests and laity and all the ministers of our church. It's always a great joy to come back to St. Meinrad, my old stomping grounds, and it's always a great honor to celebrate ordinations. It's a special joy and honor this year because three of the four are ours, are mine. And we have several priests here in the choir to make sure we keep them, so that's a great thing. But as we gather today, it's a day of great joy for the church, local, universal, United States, Korea, all places. And we give thanks to God. But as we begin this liturgy, we call to mind our sins. We call to mind in this octave of Easter the great joy of celebrating Jesus' victory over sin and death, and being always aware, fully aware, of how much that is essential to our lives, especially as we call to mind our sins, to prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
O God, who by the abundance of your grace give increase to the peoples who believe in you, look with favor on those you have chosen and clothe with blessed immortality those reborn through the sacrament of baptism, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Observing the boldness of Peter and John, and perceiving them to be an uneducated, ordinary men, the leaders, elders, and scribes were amazed, and they recognized them as the companions of Jesus. Then, when they saw the man who had been cured standing there with them, they could say nothing in reply. So they ordered them to leave the Sanhedrin and conferred with one another, saying, "What are we to do with these men? Everyone living in Jerusalem knows that a remarkable sign was done through them, and we cannot deny it. But so that it may not be spread any further among the people, let us give them a stern warning never again to speak to anyone in this name." So they called them back and ordered them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus. Peter and John, however, said to them in reply, "Whether it is right in the sight of God for us to obey you rather than God, you be the judges. It is impossible for us not to speak about what we have seen and heard." After threatening them further, they released them, finding no way to punish them on account of the people who were all praising God for what had happened. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yet he has not delivered me to death. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus had risen, early on that first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had driven seven demons. She went and told his companions, who were mourning and weeping. When they heard that he was alive and had been seen by her, they did not believe. After this, he appeared in another form, to two of them, walking along on their way to the country. They returned and told the others, but they did not believe them either. But later, as the 11 were at table, Jesus appeared to them and rebuked them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they had not believed those who had seen him after he had been raised. He said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these men, our brothers, to the responsibility of the diaconate.
Do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those concerned with their formation, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and of our Savior, Jesus Christ, we choose these, our brothers, for the order of the diaconate. I am not much of a shopper. I don't know if that's ever been admitted here in the Handy Church. Well, that's because they're not worldly, but we are. I am. I'm talking about myself. But most of us like a bargain or a sale, like getting two things for the price of one. Today's ordination of these four men to holy orders involves a two-for-one process of discernment. According to the program of priestly formation, the sixth edition, the new edition, a judgment concerning the suitability of a candidate to receive the diaconate as a transitional step to priesthood includes a judgment concerning his suitability for priestly ministry. It is not possible to admit a candidate to the diaconate in the face of doubts concerning his suitability for the priesthood. For this reason, the judgment reached by the scrutiny undertaken with a view to ordination to the diaconate is decisive. The program goes on to say, one who is ordained a deacon, however, is required to exercise the diaconal order for a suitable period of time before being ordained to the priesthood. Now that's from the program of priestly formation. I want to add, just because the word here is decisive, doesn't mean you're not done. So don't go thinking you can slack off. While maintaining an eye toward the ordination of these men to the priesthood, we do not want to make light of this day and the months of diaconal ministry in which these deacons will be engaged. Formation and education, after all, is ongoing. That opening prayer for the collect of this day speaks of the essential nature of baptism. When you ordain deacons, when you ordain priests, what have you, always remember that rootedness of our baptism, each of us in our vocation, that call to holiness and mission, that reminder for us that conversion is a lifelong process of conforming ourselves to Christ, being and remaining Christ-centered. We especially, as deacons and priests and bishops, must keep this in mind. For if we do not, we preach ourselves rather than Jesus Christ. The deacon has an opportunity to hone his sacramental, liturgical, and pastoral skills in a very unique way. Diaconate ministry includes assisting at the altar, proclaiming the gospel, preaching the homily, presiding at baptisms and weddings, leading various forms of liturgical services and pastoral outreach. It is said that the first cardinals would speak to the newly elected pope, who would take the name of Francis, told him not to forget the poor. These are very wise words for any deacon. Diaconate ministry is especially meant to be at the service of the poor, the vulnerable, the sick, the elderly, the marginalized. The most effective means of any ministry or service requires that one rely not so much on personal merit or talent as on the Lord, what we often refer to as the grace of holy orders. In the words of St. John the Baptist, the ordained minister must always seek to decrease that the Lord may increase. This requires that our lives and ministry be rooted in a life. In addition to the universal prayer of the church, we must cultivate a continuous rhythm of personal prayer, reflection, scripture study, spiritual reading, and examination of conscience. Not every once in a while, but regularly, at least daily. We must never forget that all ministry is meant to ultimately lead others to an encounter with the person of Jesus Christ, our hope and salvation. When necessary, in fact, we need the wisdom, humility, and courage to know when to get out of the way. The church calls deacons to embrace the threefold disciplines of prayer, celibacy, and obedience, to give oneself completely to others in imitation of Jesus Christ.
These threefold disciplines are meant to enable the sacred minister to serve all those entrusted to his care, including those who may not necessarily share the same ecclesiology or preference of the minister. We are called to serve all of God's people, and the best way of doing so is by remembering that those we serve do not belong to us, but to God. It is no accident that the church refers to itself as the body of Christ, the people of God. May those being called to the rank of the diaconate today bear in mind that the message of sacred scripture on this Saturday in the octave of Easter, through the sacred disciplines of your office, may you be bold like John and Peter in the Acts of the Apostles. May you keep your minds and hearts fixed on the will of God, meditating on the Word of God and embracing the teachings of the Catholic faith, rather than succumbing to the egos and ideologies of humanity. Like Mary Magdalene in the Gospel of Mark, may you never grow weary of seeking and proclaiming the good news of salvation in your witness to the crucified and risen Lord Jesus Christ. Through sacred ordination to the first rank of holy orders, you are hereby commissioned. Go into the world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. May you do it with a pastoral heart and with the joy of our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear sons, before you proceed to the order of the diaconate, you must declare before the people your resolve to undertake this office. Do you resolve to be consecrated for the ministry of the church through the laying on of my hands and the gift of the Holy Spirit? Do you resolve to discharge with humble charity the office of the diaconate so as to assist the priestly order and to benefit the Christian people? Do you resolve to hold fast to the mystery of the faith with a clear conscience, as the Apostle says, and to proclaim this faith by word and deed according to the gospel and the church's tradition? Do you resolve to keep this commitment? Those of you who are prepared to embrace the celibate state, do you resolve to keep this commitment perpetually as a sign of the dedication of your life to Christ the Lord for the sake of the kingdom of heaven in service to God and others? Do you resolve to guard and increase the spirit of prayer proper to your way of life and in keeping with this spirit in the circumstances of your life to celebrate faithfully the liturgy of the hours with and for the people of God, and indeed for the whole world? Do you resolve to conform your manner of life always to the example of Christ, whose body and blood you will handle at the altar? Anthony, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Amen.
JB, do you promise respect and obedience to your ordinary?
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Amen.
Sam, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God has begun the good work in you. Bring it to fulfillment. Bobby, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors?
I do.
May God has begun the good work in you. Bring it to fulfillment.
Let us go to the altar of God to join our prayer to those of all the saints, for our brothers who are to be with us.
Let us pray, dearly beloved, that God, the Almighty Father, will, in his mercy, pour out the grace of his blessing on these, his servants, whom he is pleased to receive into the sacred order of the diaconate.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy Mary, Mother of Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Peter and Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray.
Ignatius of Antioch,
pray for us.
Saint Lawrence,
pray for us.
Saint Vincent,
pray for us.
Saint Perpetua and Saint Felicity,
pray for us.
Saint Agnes,
pray for us.
Saint Gregory,
pray for us.
Saint Augustine,
pray for us.
Saint Athanasius,
pray for us.
Saint Basil,
pray for us.
Saint Ephrem,
pray for us.
Saint Martin,
pray for us.
Saint Benedict,
pray for us.
Saint Francis,
pray for us.
Saint Dominic,
pray for us.
Saint Patrick,
pray for us.
Saint Jose Sanchez del Rio,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us.
Saint Bernadette,
pray for us.
Saint Anne,
pray for us.
Saint Martha,
pray for us.
Saint Alphonsus Liguori,
pray for us.
Saint Francis de Sales,
pray for us.
Saint Thomas Aquinas,
pray for us.
All Korean martyrs,
pray for us.
Saint Francis Xavier,
pray for us.
Saint Theodora Guerin,
pray for us.
Saint John Vianney,
pray for us.
Saint Catherine of Siena,
pray for us.
Saint Teresa of Jesus,
pray for us.
All holy men and women, saints of God,
pray for us.
Lord, be merciful.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from all evil.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from every sin.
Lord, deliver us, we pray,
from everlasting death.
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your incarnation,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By your death and resurrection,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
By the outpouring of the Holy Spirit,
Lord, deliver us, we pray.
Merciful to us sinners,
Lord, we ask you hear our prayer.
Govern and protect your holy church,
Lord, we ask you hear our prayer.
Keep the Pope and all all ordained in faithful service to your church.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Bless these chosen men.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Bless and sanctify these chosen men.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Bless, sanctify, and consecrate these chosen men.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Bring all peoples together in peace and true harmony.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Comfort all the troubled and afflicted with your mercy.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Strengthen us and keep us in your holy service.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Jesus, Son of the living God.
Glory as you hear our prayer.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Lord God, mercifully hear our prayers, and kindly accompany with your help what we are about to do by virtue of our office. Sanctify with your blessing those whom in our judgment we believe are worthy to be offered for the exercise of sacred ministries. Through Christ our Lord.
Draw near, we pray, Almighty God, giver of every grace, who apportion every order and assign every office. While remaining unchanged, you make all things new, and setting all things in order with everlasting providence, you make due provision for every age, through your word, your power, and your wisdom, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. You grant that your church, his body, adorned with manifold heavenly graces, drawn together in the diversity of her members and united by a wondrous bond through the Holy Spirit, should grow and spread forth to build up a new temple. As once you chose the sons of Levi to minister in the former tabernacle, so now you establish three ranks of ministers in their sacred offices to serve your name. Thus, in the first days of your church, your sons apostles, led by the Holy Spirit, appointed seven men of good repute to help them in the daily ministry, so that they might devote themselves more fully to prayer and the preaching of the word. By prayer and the laying on of hands, they entrusted to these chosen men the ministry of serving at table. Look favorably also on these your servants, we pray, O Lord, whom we humbly dedicate to serve at your holy altars in the office of the diaconate. Send forth the Holy Spirit upon them, O Lord, we pray, that they may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace to carry out faithfully the work of the ministry. May every evangelical virtue abound in them, unfeigned love, concern for the sick and the poor, unassuming authority, the purity of innocence, and the observance of spiritual discipline. May your precepts shine forth in their conduct, that by the example of their manner of life, they may inspire the imitation of your holy people. In offering the witness of a good conscience, may they remain firm and steadfast in Christ, so that imitating your Son on earth, who came not to be served but to serve, they may be found worthy to reign with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Deacon Anthony, receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Peace be with you. Deacon J.B., receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach.
Amen.
Deacon Sam, receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach.
Amen.
Deacon Bobby, receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good and all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, with the order of bishops, these your servants who have been ordained today as ministers for the church, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter your room,
but only say,
Say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Don't they look good? They look wonderful. I'm standing on about a 6-inch platform here, and I'm almost looking eye to eye to Deacon Anthony. And I'm looking eye to eye to two of the others, and one we see eye to eye on the rest of the time. Again, I want to echo my thanks again to Father Dennis, to you and your entire staff and faculty, and all the great work here at St. Meinrad over the many, many years. Only a few as bad as me got through, but otherwise you produced some great, great guys. And to Archabbot Kurt for the monastery, for the great work. I confess at the beginning of my homily to not liking shopping. I apologize. I got charcoal or something all over this vestment, so I will go shopping and find something to fix this, I guess. I do apologize for that. I thank all the priests who have been able to come here today and all the deacons. To all the families, thank you for all that you've done to nurture and sustain these four men for life and for ministry, and to keep doing the work, which means keep them grounded, keep them humble. Don't let them forget who they are as baptized Christians, first and foremost, so that they live more fully their diaconal ministry and beyond. So Andy and the choir, thank you all for making the trip to get here. We're so grateful for leaving us so beautiful in song. I hope I haven't forgotten anyone, but if I did, I apologize. Oh, Father Thomas, our MC, Father Thomas lost his father this morning very unexpectedly. I want you to be assured of our prayers. So God bless you. I've been thinking about your father all through the Mass, and we're certainly holding our prayers and your family. God bless you. Please hold me in your prayers as well, and for all those who have to put up with me, they'll definitely appreciate it. Let us ask for those blessings. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, who has called you to the service of others in his church, give you great zeal for all, especially the afflicted and the poor.
Amen.
May he who has entrusted you with preaching the gospel of Christ help you as you live according to his word to be its sincere and fervent witnesses.
Amen.
May he who has appointed you stewards of his mysteries make you imitations of his Son, Jesus Christ, and ministers of unity and peace in the world.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. 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 Good morning. I just want to let you know that we have midday prayer at noon today for the monastery. So if you wouldn't mind going ahead and moving toward your lunch, that would help us collect ourselves as we gather for midday prayer. Thank you.